someone would have told me years ago that living a raw vegan lifestyle would transform my life, I would have been like, what? Raw vegan? Plant-based? What is that? I would never believed it. I didn't even know what raw vegan or plant-based was, nor had I ever even heard of it. In my mind, I was already living a healthy lifestyle. But looking back, I was so far off. My face was constantly breaking out, leaving me with nasty acne scars. I fluctuated in weight between 138 and 145, with my ideal weight being between 125 and 130. Not too bad, but for me, I wanted to weigh somewhere between 125 and 130. So for me, it was a big deal. I wasn't sleeping well. I'd have nightmares, wake up abruptly, and at times I just couldn't sleep at all. Then there were times where I felt lethargic, fatigued, and energy drained. I was seeking happiness in all the wrong places, which I'm sure so many of you can relate. I lost my identity and sense of self. Although it may not have seemed that way to others, I did a great job covering it up. I couldn't keep going like this and knew something had to change, but those changes didn't come right away. They came in small doses over the years until I started making some serious changes. So what did I do? I began to raise my vibration and adjust my environment. I shifted away from what no longer served me to more of what did. I began to learn more about true health, wellness, and nutrition. I cultivated a positive mindset and began to shift my focus away from how things were to how I wanted them to be. That, my friend, was the beginning of my healing journey and the end of my toxic one. It was all a true blessing in disguise, one that came one day at a time, one step at a time. You see, living a raw vegan lifestyle is more than just eating raw food. It's a complete lifestyle shift and a holistic way of life, mind, body, and spirit. One that is so eye-opening and enriching that you won't ever want to look back. You learn to create a life of true happiness and gain a new appreciation for the world around you. Most importantly, you learn to love yourself unconditionally. But here's a fair warning. Transitioning to a raw vegan lifestyle can dramatically change and improve the quality of your life. It can enhance your mental awareness and improve your brain function. It can lead you to lose excess body weight and stubborn fat. It can take your energy levels to heights you never imagined. It can potentially reverse illness and disease, boost your confidence, self-love, and ultimately lead you to a life of optimal health while creating a life you truly love. When you realize that this is a lifestyle and not just a diet, and commit to making permanent lifestyle shifts versus continuing to search for shortcuts, quick fixes, or justify toxic habits, you won't ever want to turn back. To help you get started, I've compiled 10 very important tips that will help you transition into a raw plant-based lifestyle. Beginning with number one, get clear on why you want to transition. It's very important that your mind and your heart are on the same page. Do you have weight loss goals you want to reach? Do you want to live a higher quality of life? Do you want to improve your energy levels and be able to do the things you enjoy for yourself and your family? Do you want to do right by the animals and the environment? Ask yourself the question why. Your why will help you get clear on the meaning behind your transition, allow you to stay focused, and ensure you achieve successful results. Number two, now this is a no-brainer. Eliminate processed and refined foods. Ditch the junk. Ditch the junk. Ditch the junk. If you want to lose weight, increase energy, improve digestion, and live a healthier quality of life, these type of foods will only continue to slow you down and further complicate your health while adding more fuel to the fire. Start working on avoiding the worst of the standard American diet type junk foods that are overcooked, greasy, sugary, salted, fat-filled, and fried. If you truly want to reverse symptoms and potentially reverse health conditions, it's time to buckle down and clean house. Number three, increase your intake of raw living foods. Buying organic, local, and seasonal when possible. Consuming raw living food is our body's natural diet and provides us with all the essential nutrients, vitamins, and minerals our body requires in order for it to fully thrive. When we eat raw fruits, vegetables, nuts, and seeds in proper food combination, we allow the body to absorb and assimilate the benefits of these nutrients successfully. So, you are not only what you eat, but what your body assimilates. The result? Healthy weight loss, increased energy, optimal digestion, glowing skin, better sleep, and ultimately, optimal health. The benefits are endless. Bottom line, stick to pure living food that is uncooked and sun-cooked instead of stove-cooked and oven-cooked. Number four, don't beat yourself up. So you fell off the wagon. Now what? It happens to the best of us. The truth is, there is no wagon and no perfect way to eat. What works for one may not work for the other. Everyone's body is different. There is no one way for everyone, which is why it is so important to consult a professional before taking on your own health independently through internet guidance. But regardless, whatever you do, don't beat yourself up. Always be forgiving and know that you always have a chance to start anew. Just don't abuse the opportunity because second or third chances don't always come around. We each have a choice. Choose wisely for yourself, your health, your body, your loved ones, and your life because ultimately your life depends on it. A healthy body is a happy body. Number five, start where you are. There is no better time or right time to start than the present. Most importantly, don't compare yourself to anyone else. It's your life and your body with no other like it. Remember that. We're each on our own individual journey. You can start your journey from wherever you are with whatever you have. Whether you're new to the raw food world, a vegan vegetarian in training, or a vegan vegetarian ready to take it to the next level. Everyone's transition and starting point will be very different. There is no direct process to getting here. Or are there any prerequisites? All that is needed is to be clear on your why, your will to succeed, and your drive to make it happen. Number six, listen to your body. Your body will always tell you what it's feeling and what it needs, so pay attention to it. A big mistake most people do is ignore the signs, and that's when you start to create more problems. Your body's nudges won't always be the same, and its needs will vary from time to time. As seasons come and go, or as you progress throughout your journey. For me, my body's needs change in the winter. Sort of. I'll tend to eat more cooked foods during the fall-winter months versus the spring or summer. Not a lot, but maybe once a week, if that. But I will say that if I feel like eating a cooked meal, I will. But I'll tell you what, when I do eat something cooked, it's not long before I feel the dehydration and begin to crave fruit. Why? Because of its high water content. It's like when summer rolls around and you gravitate towards raw, juicy fruit because you're thirsty and you need something more refreshing. For me, that's what it feels like all year round. My body is so used to eating raw living food that when it doesn't, it quickly feels the effects. Remember, if you do right by your body, it will always do right by you. Number seven, change your relationship with food. We are not born to love eating healthy foods. We develop eating habits by what we are introduced with and begin eating from day one. Our behavior is learned, and just as it is learned, it can be unlearned. It all depends on you. Yes, it is much easier to reach for the bagged, packaged foods and fast foods versus being inclined to put a healthy meal together when you're feeling down, stressed, bored, or if you don't have enough food supply in your kitchen. What you stock or don't stock in your pantry or kitchen is what you end up resorting to. So if ice cream, cake, chips, or other junk food snacks is what you constantly keep on hand, then you will always continue to reach for them first, especially if you are in an emotional state of being. As you train your body to adjust to healthful living foods and what is intended for us by nature, you'll begin to naturally detach yourself from your emotional addiction to junk food. And you'll find yourself developing a desire for real, whole, nutrient-rich foods. You'll feel so good that eating raw living foods will remain front and center as you continue marching on. Number eight, don't deprive yourself. This isn't about restrictions or deprivation. As your body begins to detoxify years of toxic buildup, you will begin to reach the peak of feeling alive and well. So be patient. However, there may come a time when you find yourself craving a certain food you used to eat, or find yourself in a situation where your meal options are limited and reaching for the nearest fast food restaurant is more convenient. Whatever it is your body is asking for, go ahead and oblige. Will you kick yourself in the butt afterward? Maybe. Will you feel your stomach turn and feel the need to hightail it to the nearest bathroom? Probably. Bottom line, if you desire it, go for it. But do know that if you do, you are reintroducing your body to highly addictive properties, making it very difficult to realign. It's all up to you. Don't let your hard work go to waste. Keep moving forward. Number 9, keep it simple. There is no need to get complicated when preparing your meals. Keep them simple and in minimal food combinations. Simple is good, and the body loves simple. This helps with bloating, gassiness, and it just makes it so much easier to eat healthy. As a matter of fact, I have found that transitioning into a raw vegan lifestyle is so much easier to make my food. Preparing my meals versus cooking them has made it so much easier and has saved me a ton of time. It's less cleanup. That's a win-win. Like with anything, there is always gonna be an adjustment period. But once you've surpassed it, you are good as golden. Be patient with your transition and just keep it simple. You'll be glad you did. Number 10, educate yourself. Knowledge is power with applied action. After all, isn't your health, your body, and your life worth it? Rest assured, you will come across people, including friends and family, who will feed you every reason as to why not, and will think you're a person gone crazy. It's okay. Don't let that derail your progress. People who react that way tend to get their panties in a bunch by what they don't understand or know very little about. The best thing you can do is set the example and be someone else's shining star. Lead the way by radiating health, vitality, and a zest for life. Some will follow and some will not. There's nothing wrong with that. Those close to you will follow in your lead soon enough. The important thing is that you educate yourself and be prepared to come back with answers and your very own results. Proven results don't lie. They do, however, inspire. One thing I have learned is that people lack the education and the necessary knowledge to embark on this journey. The internet does a great job at confusing and overwhelming you while putting you in a position where you don't know what direction to take and if the direction you are taking is even accurate. Picking up bits and pieces here and there along the way don't pave the way. It only leads you to a crossroads, filling you with even more confusion and frustration than what you started with. I know this because I've been there. I was once an internet victim. I always turned to the internet for answers and direction. Let's face it, it's the largest go-to system for answers. The truth is, the answers aren't always correct, which is why I am here to tell you that you should never solely guide yourself by everything you see and read online. Seek expert guidance from a certified professional such as a holistic nutrition practitioner or a holistic health practitioner. Do your research well and seek a consultation before deciding. It's so important to do what's best for you and stop trying to find shortcuts. There are no shortcuts to optimal health, no matter what commercialized products claim they can do for you. Organic, fresh, wholesome, raw living foods is your best medicine and your number one source for optimal health. It's healthcare at its finest. So tell me, what stage are you in? Are you in transition? Thinking about transitioning? And if you are, what is your biggest struggle? Let me know in the comments below. If you found this video helpful in any way, please give it a thumbs up. It helps to support my channel when you do. Thank you so much for watching and being a part of my growing YouTube community. And if you haven't yet subscribed, don't forget to hit the subscribe button below for more lifestyle and inspirational videos to come. Until the next one, stay safe, be well, be kind, and keep aligning with your best self.